soiled clothes, what I'd done gardening in, smelling of horse, the biggest hair you've ever seen in your life. And my friends are happy to see me, but they're very concerned. My name's Amy Christine Stella Gledhill.
Ooh.
She's got two middle names. Is she a bit fancy? Or is she trash? Thank you for all saying the same word in your head then, yes. I was a really creepy kid. Do we have any other creepy kids in? Yeah, of course you are. You're at a comedy night in a theatre. Of course you're a little bit creepy. I was a really creepy kid. And I was very, very ginger, very pale, exquisitely well-behaved. It's so gross. And the thing I wanted most in the world was a puppy, right? Oh, my God. I wanted a puppy so bad. And I'd ask every single day. And every day, my parents would say, no, we've got seven kids. Absolutely no chance. I bet, please. And it got to the point where I was very earnestly dragging around a rock on a piece of string. Please. If I can look after this, I can look after a puppy. And eventually, they relented and they let me get one. And I think it's because I was so creepy. They thought if I didn't, I'd kill them in their sleep. So they're like, give her a dog. Give her a dog, for God's sake, Christine. And we went. I picked the runt of the litter because it felt like me. And we got it home. Oh, my God. It was the best day of my life. And we got it home. I loved it so much. And we realised almost immediately that I was severely allergic to it. I was so allergic to that dog. Couldn't breathe properly. My eyes would water. And everywhere it touched me, I went red and blotchy. So my parents had no choice but to keep it for 17 years. 2 years in, they thought I looked lonely. They got another one. That is the behaviour of parents with children to burn. when I was in my 20s, I had a boyfriend who was a bit younger than me, right? And he was going to plan my birthday as a romantic gesture. And because he was a bit younger, he had all the enthusiasm for romance, but none of the finesse, right? What he did, he said, I'm planning your birthday. Woke up that morning and he said the words, I think we all want to hear as a woman. He said, just wear your clothes. Where we go in the sewers? Don't mind if I do. He said, just wear your clothes. I was like, right, okay. So I did put my clothes on and he took me horse riding. Like, fine, you know, sure. I'd never shown any interest in horse riding in my entire life. And he took me horse riding. And I don't know if there's any animal experts or anything in tonight, but I don't know if you know, but a horse is actually like a really big dog. I was so allergic to them horses. Oh, my God. So we stepped on onto the stables and immediately I couldn't breathe. I'm wheezing, sneezing, my eyes are watering and red. I've got these hives all over my face. But I didn't want to be ungrateful. So I went for a little trot. And I was like, right, thank you. I've had a lovely day. I'd like to go home. And he said, oh, no. The day's not over yet. Right, it's just I'm in my clothes. I haven't got a change of clothes and I'm covered in hives and I can't breathe. He said, well, I've booked you into a spa. So, okay. And he booked me in for a head massage, right? Again, I'd never had one. And we went and the lady said, do you mind if I use oil? And I said, I don't know. Do you usually use oil? And she said, well, I wouldn't if you're going out afterwards, but... So, yeah, it's my clothes, right, yeah. So you fill your boots, use the oil, fill your boots. So she's pouring oil on my head and she's massaging my head for nearly an hour, right? And it felt lovely, but my hair is getting bigger and bigger and oilier and oilier. And after the hour, because I've got huge hair and red eyes and I'm wheezing and sneezing and I'm in my clothes, I look like I've had a very severe mental health breakdown. I say, right. Thank you very much. I've had a lovely day. I'd like to go home now. And he said, oh, no. No, no, no. The day is not over yet. And what he'd done is he'd arranged for me to meet 6 of my fittest friends in a cocktail bar in Leeds. No change of clothes. I was like, right, no antihistamines. I was like, right, okay. So I turn up to this cocktail bar in, like, soiled clothes what I'd done gardening in, smelling of horse, the biggest hair you've ever seen in your life. And my friends are happy to see me, but they're very concerned. They're very concerned. And they do that thing, they're like, hi. I was like, nothing's happened, I've had a lovely day. And it wasn't the best birthday, but the worst part was definitely when I had to untag myself from the worst picture of anyone you've ever seen in your life, because we'd all lined up, we'd got us all lined up for the picture, and it looked like the Kardashians were visiting Mick Hucknall after he'd had an accident. It was awful. Right, that's my time. Thank you so much. I've been Amy Christine Selleck-Lytle. Thank you. Bye-bye.